There he is.
So how you feel, man?
I feel like pressing on.
That's
by the grace of God. By the grace of God.
That's what's happening. Pressing on.
That's right. I'm very happy.
All
right. Make 40 years, I'm very happy. Actually, it's tomorrow. Okay. The day is tomorrow.
Right.
But I'm happy to make it to that point.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. God is good, man.
Yes, sir. All the time.
All the time.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the celebration and blessings of 40 years of marriage honoring Sylvester and Gillie Webber. Ecclesiastes 3:1 says, to everything there is a season. There's a time to every purpose under heaven. This afternoon, we are fulfilling Ecclesiastes 3. For you see, over 40 years, this couple came together in a season or time where they laughed. They had times where they mourned. There was a time where they danced or rejoiced. But there also came a time where they stopped to embrace. In a lifetime with a partner, there comes a time when you stop embracing. You accumulate things, and over time, you lose those things. Well, in losing those things, you keep some and you throw some away. As a woman of God, there's a time when you have to learn not to speak and just plain old be quiet. But there's also a time when the husbandman learns to refrain from speaking and keep silence. In a marriage, there's a time to love. And that is how we all came here today, to celebrate the love, the marriage, the blessings of this couple on today. You see, love brought them together. And if they continue to trust in God, He will keep them together. So welcome to this celebration in honor of Sylvester and Gillie Webber. Thank you. Dear God, upon this ceremony, you see the time and the effort that has been put into this, dear God. We thank you, Lord God, for the invitations, dear God, Lord, that have been sent out, those who were able to make it through the inclement weather, dear God. We just appreciate all that you have done. And now we're just asking your continual blessings throughout the furtherance of this service. In Jesus' name. Amen. The scripture reading is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 7. Now concerning the things whereof ye wrote unto me, it is good for a man not to touch a woman. Nevertheless, to avoid fornication, let every man have his own wife, and let every woman have her own husband. Let the husband render unto the wife due benevolence, and likewise also the wife unto the husband. The wife hath not power over her own body, but the husband. And likewise also the husband hath not power over his own body, but the wife. Defraud ye not one the other, except it be with consent for a time, that ye may give yourselves to fasting and prayer, and come together again, that Satan tempt you not for your incontinency. But he that is married careth for the things. But he that is married careth for the things that are of the world, how he may please his wife.
Amen.
There is a difference also between a wife and a virgin. The unmarried woman careth for the things of the Lord, that she may be holy in body and in spirit. But she that is married careth for the things of the world, how she may please her husband. Thank God for the reading of his
word. I just want to emphasize, I was asked to give remarks as well, I just want to emphasize the words due benevolence. First, I'm going to give you the definition of benevolence, which means desire to promote the happiness of others. And in this case, Brother Sylvester and Sister Gillie. Goodwill, kindly feeling, generosity, and a generous gift. But the word due was placed before the word benevolence. So basically, God is saying here that as husband and wives, we continually are in debt. We continually owe each other that kindness, that happiness. It's due. Due means owed as a debt. We're constantly in each other's debt to be generous, to be kind, as husbands and wives. Due means to be paid as a right. It is that spouse's right for the other spouse to be generous to him and vice versa. Due means unpaid. You ever had a deal that the more you pay, you still pay? Well, similar to benevolence and kindness in a relationship between a husband and a wife, we should never stop being kind.
Amen.
It also says, as much as needed, it is looked for. So to Brother Sylvester and Sister Gillie, that's what you had to be doing to get to this point, 40 years, and we're praying that God will continue to bless you. And just to say what I know about Brother and Sister Webber, they carry a burden for their family, for the lost souls and sin. I remember their being one of the couples who sort of spearheaded a trip to Tunica to reach out to their friends and different ones that they grew up with. They've also supported me in track meetings. I've had the opportunity to work with Sister Gillie with the single sisters. And Brother Sylvester has been working with Stepping Stones, or was working with Stepping Stones. So basically, the two of them have been a blessing to us and to the Sunday school class. Brother Webber was able to teach some of the Sunday school classes, also memorizing and reciting the verses. So I really count it an honor to be here today to be able to witness this great celebration. God bless you, Brother Sylvester and Sister Gillie.
Flesh of my flesh, bone of my bone. There's no one closer. You are flesh of my flesh, bone of my bone. We are one. I do pledge my life. Shower you with grace.
Ladies and gentlemen, please allow me a few minutes for a short speech of a 40-year journey. My name is Jalen Gibson, son of Latanya Gibson and my grandparents, Gillie and Sylvester Webber. On May 19, 1979, On May 19, 1979, these two came together, and today we are celebrating 40 years of 40 years of being together as husband and wife, building a life side by side. 40 years of supporting each other. 40 years of total commitment, knowing that God was in this plan, and that this 40 years would turn into a forever love. During this 40 years of marriage, there were three different houses they called home, seven loving children, 11 sweet grandchildren, and three adorable great-grandkids. 40 years of love and support from their siblings, and what would life be without their friends that they call family? Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to witness 40 years of love, not just from this lovely couple, but also from the 40 couples that will come down the center aisle today. Yeah, you heard me right. 40 couples will represent each year that my grandparents have been married. These couples are family and friends that have traveled far and near to express their love and support to my grandparents, Gillie and Sylvester Webber. So as I bring this speech to a close, I would just like to say happy 40th wedding anniversary to my grandma and papa. Let's celebrate and honor the best of God.
Joy, all that's good and perfect comes from
Hope for all that you do.
pleasure in the simple things in life. Bought you the music in my meadow and the spring. Oh, the voices of the children, my family and my home. Oh, you are the source and finish of my from this day, there's no more beyond us. From this day, I will. This day, I feel. From this day, it's gonna be so real, so much. I remember people saying it wouldn't be, but with my touch on any beautiful gown, we'll make it story. Forever and ever, through good and bad weather, our love will remain, even though the seasons may change. Forever and ever, for so forever, our love will remain, even though the seasons may change. From this day, I find this day your mind. From this day, I'm sure about what love has done. From this day, a dream this day, a team from this day. God has blessed me with everything and then some. I remember people say it wouldn't be, but with my tux on and your beautiful gown, we'll make history. Yeah, all forever.
Forever, our love will remain. Scripture says that we will rejoice and be glad in it. The song said, I have so much to thank God for. He made ways for me. He opened doors that I could not see. So I have so much to thank God for. 40 years of being married, that is few and far between. 40 years of being married. 7 children. After 32 years working for construction, Brother Webber retired. That's enough right there to thank God for. Mahalie Jackson said, how I got over. She said, when I look back, my soul wondered how I got over. How did we make it through the struggle? Food stamps?
Yeah.
Food pantries?
Course.
Government cheese, cheese in the grits, cheese in the rice, cheese on the fries, cheese in the egg. My God, wonder we ain't dead. This couple love God, and they have been faithful down through the years. The Bible said that it is required in stewardship that a man be found faithful. Brother Webber been faithful, and Sister Webber been faithful to the trustee board for the usher board for over 35 years. Brother Webber been head of the usher board for over 20 years. That is enough right here to give God some praise. And as being the head of the Urshan board, Brother Webber believed in doing things decently and in order. He said, just like God gave you commission, Pastor Hodges, to preach the gospel, God gave me a permit, gave me a job, and my job is to make sure things are done decently and in order. So he keep pressure on everybody around here. From Sister Webber to Jalen as being a new Urshan. He believed in that. I wrote a few things down because I'm getting up there in age too. Sister Webber, the scripture comes to my mind, Proverbs 31:28. Her children arise up and call her blessed. Her husband also shall praise her. It is amazing how you cover so many bases for your family. How you burn both ends of the candle. Taking care of your children. Taking care of your grandchildren. Recently, I have devotion with Jalen in the morning, early in the morning. Sister Webber getting up, taking them to the train station. It is amazing how you burn both ends of the candle, taking care of your family. The last year and a half has really been a challenge for you. With the sickness coming down on Brother Webber, the way, sister, you have stood by your man, the way you have supported Brother Webber, you have had Brother Webber back. You've been there encouraging him. You've been there strengthening him. You tell Brother Webber if you're going to be sick, you might as well be sick at church. Come on, let's go. And recently, I noticed that you're not calling him Brother Webber so much. Now you start Nitty. I guess y'all having a relapse. Going back to y'all teenage day. Fur your can on. Nitty. you have been a great woman of God, and you've been a great wife, and you've been a great mother. Brother Webber, you have been a faithful man of God. And the scripture that came to my mind was Proverbs 20:7. It said, a just man walketh in his integrity. His children are blessed after him. And brother, you walk in your integrity. You walk with your head up high. You walk like a soldier. You walk like you're still, on the west side packing. Me and my wife, we went to the same beauty shop, and I had that big pistol by my side. But you walk in your integrity. I can remember many times having a conversation. We're around the same age. Mm-hmm. And we would talk about how we are so blessed for the teaching that we receive. We would talk about how Pastor Gordon was such a strong man of God, and how Brother Duggar was such a strong man of God, and thank God for the teaching that we receive.
Amen.
And Pastor Gordon used to say, the home first.
Yeah. That's right.
The family second. And if there's anything left, you can have it.
Right.
And a lot of times, there wouldn't be nothing left. Brother Duggar used to tell us about the three L's.
Right.
The leader.
Lover.
The laborer and the lover.
Amen.
And brother, you have proven to be all three of those.
Amen.
You have commanded your house to follow after you. You've been a leader. Every Sunday morning as we was growing up, you had your children, your family in church. Sunday school to night church service, you took point. You was the leader of that household. You was the leader. And you was the labor. Mm-hmm. Brother Doug would preach so hard, he'll make us scared to come to church. Brother Frank Miller would say, y'all know that man ain't acting right. Get his hand and bring him to the altar.
Bring him in.
Bring him in. They would tell us it's not too cold to go to work. It's not too hard to go to work.
That's right.
Take care of your family.
That's right. That's right.
And that teaching was instilled within us.
Right.
Then on top of that, love your wife.
Love the wife.
And Brother Webber, you have did just that. And I commend you. You have done an awesome job. So God bless you and your wife.
Thank you.
This day is your day. Enjoy it. At this time, they have remarks one to another.
Mention why we redo our vows.
Here, you going first.
No, you go first.
I'd like to say, first of all, I'd like to say I thank God for being saved, being redeemed from sin, miserable life of sin and shame. And I'd like to say that I love my wife.
Amen.
Out of all the millions and millions of women in this world, I feel I got the best one.
Praise the Lord.
Of course. Of course. I feel I got the best one. Out of all the women in the world, I got the best one. I do, Brother Webber. I got the best one. I love you with all my heart, soul, mind, and strength. Then, since I've been saved, and you know this for a fact, I haven't been with another woman since I've been saved. All my love and stuff goes to you. And I want you to know that I love you very much. And you my wife, my girlfriend, my woo-woo.
He's feeling pretty good.
You're all a thing to me. And I appreciate how you're taking care of my children. You've been a blessing. You've been a blessing to me. And what really proved my wife, see, talk is cheap. What really proves you, baby, is when you how you taking care of me since I've been sick.
Yes.
With this affliction on me. See, talk is cheap. But when somebody go down their body, it's something about people seem to forget about you or whatever. They get tired. My wife been there with me all the way. All the way. And I appreciate that. I love you very much. Baby, I pray we have many more years together. Oh, Just before she start, I don't want nobody feeling get hurt or anything like this, what I'm about to say. My wife and I are not doing the vows. I know you're probably looking for the vows, and you know, a lot of people ask me, are you going to do the vows? Me and my wife came up with this conclusion that if it's not broke, why try to fix it?
Oh, okay, bro, well.
Me and my wife, we've been consistent. We love each other. No, we're not reading the vows. I ain't got nothing against it, but we, if it's not broke, why try to fix it? Mine's not broke.
So I end up writing mine down. Oh. 40 years ago, I pledged my love and commitment to you. But it seems like only yesterday. I promised to love you, honor you, comfort, and obey you.
All right.
I pledged to be by your side in sickness.
You've been there. You're doing it right now.
Mm-hmm. Bless the Lord. In sickness.
Yeah.
And in health.
Right.
In times of want.
Right.
In times of plenty. For the better, for the worse. Today, at the beginning of our 40th year as husband and wife, in the presence of God and our family and friends, I pledge my eternal love for you. You are the man for me.
Wow. That's some hot stuff there.
I think we got a divine touch today. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we come before you. My God, we are so grateful and we are so thankful for the privilege and opportunity to come before you. We thank you, Lord God, for being God, and beside you, there is no other. We thank you, Lord God, that you spoke and it was. You command and it stood fast. We thank you, Lord God, for blessing brother and sister Webber, dear God, and Father, one day saving them and redeeming them, and my God, giving them a brand new heart, giving them a brand new mind. And we thank you, Lord God, for saving them, washing them, making them clean. Father, we thank you, Lord God, how you have blessed them down through the years. Father, they had their good times. They had their bad times. My God, they have their struggles. But Lord God, through it all, you have blessed them abundantly. And to God be the glory for the things that he have done. Things so undeserving you have gave to prove your love. The voices of a million angels cannot express our gratitude. So all that I am and ever hope to be, we owe it all to thee. My God, we thank God for this holy family, dear God. And my God, how you have blessed Brother Webber even in this body, dear God. Father, the way you have touched this body, the way you have strengthened him in this body, the way, Father, you have blessed Sister Webber, giving her strength, dear God, to support her husband. Father, we praise God for it. Now, Lord, we pray, you continue to bless this event. This has been a glorious event. My God, this has been an awesome event, Lord. Father, so many people, dear God, have fell by the wayside, went their separate ways, reestablished, Lord God, different families. But, Lord, you have blessed them. You have kept them together through the good, through the bad, Lord. Father, you have blessed them abundantly, and we praise you for it. Now be with them, dear God, the remainders of this day. Lord, what's accomplished, we'll honor you and praise you. In Jesus' name, praise God. Amen.
Amen.
Hold it in the heart. When stars go out each night,
stars go out each night,
remind us where we are,
remind us where you are.
Let this be our prayer,
let this be our prayer.
When shadows fill our day,
it's too hard.